The Senate will come to order. Ask everyone present to please rise and recite the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. The Rabbi Shmuel Buttman, director of Lubavitch Movement in Brooklyn, New York, will deliver today's invocation. Rabbi?
Let us pray. Avinu Shebashamayim, our Heavenly Father, please bestow your blessings upon the members of the New York State Senate, especially as they are passing a resolution, the resolution honoring the Rebbe, the Lubavitcher Rebbe, with 121 days of education in the state of New York. The whole world is worried about safety and security. The people in Crown Heights are worried about safety and security. The people in Brooklyn are worried about safety and security. The people in New York State are worried about safety and security. The people in the United States are worried about safety and security. The people in Israel, the people in Europe, the people in the Middle East, everyone is worried about safety and security. And for good reason, every mother wants to see their children grow up and their children's children grow up and have a lot of prosperity and so on. The Rebbe says that there is one way that we can assure that there should be safety and security in this world, and that is by educating our children, not when they're 19 or 20 years old, because when he is 19 and she is 19, that may be a little too late, by starting early. The Rebbe always said, and he said it so many times, when he's speaking about education, he means education of all children, regardless of race and religion, of all children. And he wants all children to know that there is an ear that hears and an eye that sees, and that the world is not a jungle. And we should start early. When you are proclaiming 121 days of education, that is going to make a big difference. The state of New York is a leading state in the United States. The United States is a leading power in the world. So this is going to have international connotations, 121 days of education. In 1991, I went to Washington to open the United States Senate. Before I went to Washington, I went to see the Rebbe. And the Rebbe said to me that while I am doing the prayer in Washington, I should put in a dollar in a tzedakah box. The tzedakah box means a charity box. And he says, and everyone should see what you are doing and let them know what money should be used for. We're going to do the same, and I am going to put in a dollar, as the Rebbe told me, in this box. Now, this box this year is new, as you can see. It's transparent, because I was told that in Albany you like transparency. So we're going to do it tonight, and we're going to ask you this afternoon, we're going to ask you, if you can, to contribute $1 for goodness and kindness. Now, this is not a fundraising campaign. Don't get scared, because if it would be, we would ask you for much more than $1. We're asking you for $1, and don't make a mistake, we don't take $5 bills. We only take $1 because that is an act of goodness and kindness. We have to change this world and make this world a better place. I also want to tell you that every single Saturday, every single Shabbos, in our shuls, we say a special prayer for you. We say, V'chol ha'oskim b'tzorchei tzibur be'emuno, all those who serve the public faithfully as you are. We're asking for a prayer that Almighty God should keep you, and he should sustain you and give you a lot of nachas. Nachas means happy tidings in your personal life and in your communal life. I also want to give you one more blessing. You should pass the budget successfully today. Amen.
Speak that budget talk into existence, Rabbi. Reading of the journal.
In Senate, Friday, March 10th, 2023, Senate member pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Thursday, March 9th, 2023, was read and approved on motion to Senate adjourn.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentation of petitions. Messages from the Assembly. Secretary will read.
Senator Manny moves to discharge from the Committee on Disabilities, Assembly Bill Number 3534, substituted for the identical Senate Bill 2494, third reading count of 343.
So ordered. Messages from the Governor. Reports of standing committees. Reports of select committees. Communications and reports from state officers. Motions and resolutions. Senator Gennaris.
Mr. President, good afternoon. Amendments are offered to the following third reading calendar bills by Senator Stavisky, calendar 238, and by Senator Mannion, calendar 317.
The amendments are received and those bills will retain their places on the third reading calendar.
I also wish to call up the following bills, which were recalled from the Assembly and are now at the desk. Senate print numbers 3609A, 4270, and 1448.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 339, Senate print 3609A by Senator Webb, an act to amend the public health law. Calendar number 355, Senate print 4270 by Senator Parker, an act to amend the agriculture and markets law. Calendar number 404, Senate print 1448 by Senator Sanders, an act to amend the education law.
Move to reconsider the vote by which these bills were passed.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Orsu, Cousins, White, ayes 55.
The bills are restored to their places on the third reading calendar.
Following amendments.
The amendments are received and those bills will retain their places on the third reading calendar.
Mr. President, at this time there's a privileged resolution at the desk. Please take that up, read its title, and recognize Senator Myrie.
There is a privileged resolution at the desk. The Secretary will read.
Senate Resolution 554 by Senator Myrie, commemorating the anniversary celebration of the birthday of the revered Lubavitcher Rebbe, Rabbi Menachem M. Schneerson.
Senator Myrie on the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. President. And first, let me extend my gratitude to Rabbi Butman for making the trip up to Albany and giving us those blessings in the invocation. We are celebrating the 121st birthday of the Rebbe, someone responsible for so much good in this world, someone responsible for unity in our communities. And I have the honor of representing Crown Heights, which is the headquarters of the Lubavitch movement. And I not only represent Crown Heights, but grew up in Crown Heights, went to school in Crown Heights. And the relationship between our friends and neighbors, both our Jewish friends and neighbors, our Black friends and neighbors, has been a staple of what Crown Heights is and what it represents. And the Rebbe was also someone who believed deeply in remaining in Crown Heights, even amongst turmoil, even amongst tragedy. He thought it was important for our Jewish friends and neighbors to remain in Crown Heights, and that is a principle that all of us can continue to uplift and uphold today. Our communities have worked together against the forces pushing us out, both Jewish residents and non-Jewish residents. And just last year, working together, we passed the Foreclosure Abuse Prevention Act, something that will continue to keep homeowners of every stripe, of every race, and every culture in their homes and protecting the wealth that they have built over generations. I believe that is in the spirit of the Rebbe, and that as a representative of this community, I am honored to honor the Rebbe every single birthday. We will continue to do so. We will continue to uplift his spirit and carry that notion that no matter what you look like, no matter where you're from, and no matter how you worship, we should do it together and for the upliftment of the entire community. So I will be voting in the affirmative, and I urge all of my colleagues to support this resolution in honor of the Rebbe's memory. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Myrie. The question is on the resolution. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. The resolution is adopted. Senator Gennaris.
Thank you, Mr. President. I believe Senator Myrie would like to open that resolution for co-sponsorship.
The resolution is open for co-sponsorship. Should you choose not to be a co-sponsor, please notify the desk.
Please call on Senator Brook for an introduction.
Senator Brook, for the purposes of an introduction.
Thank you, Mr. President, for allowing me this time to introduce our special guests with us today. I want to welcome the students and youth advocates here with the Hillside Work Scholarship Connection Program. These students are here today from Binghamton, Syracuse, Greece, a suburb of Rochester, New York, where Senator Cooney represents, and parts of the city of Rochester, where I proudly represent. So on behalf, there they are, hello. On behalf of the legislature, thank you for making the trip here to Albany and being advocates, and for showing all of us how much this program does to help set our young people up for success. This program improves graduation rates, helps students navigate the college application process, find their first job. The team at Hillside is really making sure that young people across our state are prepared for life after high school and have the tools that they need to thrive. Thus, Mr. President, I ask that we welcome these guests and extend to them the courtesies and privileges of the House. Welcome. Sure. Can you...
To our guests, I welcome you on behalf of the Senate. We extend to you all of the privileges and courtesies of this House. Please rise and be recognized. Senator Gennaris.
Please take up the reading of the calendar.
The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 195, Senate Print 1732 by Senator Mayer, an act to amend the education law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, the section taking effect on the 1st of September.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gennaris, Cooper, Orsula, Cousins, Weick.
Announce the results.
Aye, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 202, Senate Print 1179 by Senator Harkham, an act to amend the environmental conservation law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gennaris, Cooper, Orsula, Cousins, Weick.
Senator Harkham to explain his vote.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. This is a measure that this body has passed twice. So at the risk of showing my age, I could just say, like Werner Wolf used to say, let's go to the videotape and air my previous remarks on this. But I rise because of the importance of this bill, which is passed in a bipartisan fashion in this House. With the hopes of educating our colleagues down the hall in the Assembly the importance of this. You know, as we advance our climate goals and our clean energy goals, one of the ways our municipalities can be helpful and serve their local constituents is with community solar, providing them with more reliability and lower cost energy right in their own communities. And we've heard of the problems about siting in public land, siting in farmland. So one of the perfect solutions is the parking lots of local parks. And we had a personal experience where a municipality came to us and the alienation process, as we know in this chamber and in the other chamber combined, can take up to a year. And in that time span, the incentives that were in place for the developer to make the deal expired. So we were thinking, why do we have to go to alienation every time we want to put a solar array over a parking lot and a town pool, a town little league field, or other town recreational facilities? So this bill allows solar installations on local parking lots only on impervious surface. So nothing impacting the green space or the recreational opportunities. This is a win-win for localities. It's a win-win for our climate goals. I thank our colleagues for your support in the past and today, and let's work to get the Assembly to pass this as well. Thank you very much.
Senator Harkin to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 202, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Griffo and Weick. Aye, 61, nays 2.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 230, Senate Print 1804 by Senator Addabbo, an act to amend the public service law.
Lay it aside.
Calendar number 272, Senate Print 2426 by Senator Passard, an act to amend the vehicle and traffic law.
Read the last section.
Section 6 actually take effect 1 year after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gennaris, Cooper, Orsula, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 272, vote in a negative, Senator Brisport, aye 62, nays 1.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 280, Senate Print 3255 by Senator Holman Siegel, an act to amend the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect on the 90th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gennaris, Cooper, Orsula, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 299, Senate print 3546 by Senator Kennedy, enactment of the New York State Urban Development Corporation Act.
Read the last section.
Section 4. This act takes effect on the 1st of April.
Call the roll.
Dabo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Kennedy to explain his vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. First of all, I want to thank my colleagues and thank the leader, Andrew Stewart Cousins, for bringing this bill to the floor today. This bill is titled the Fresh Act, the Food Retail Establishment Subsidization for Healthy Communities. A fancy way of saying our communities that have food deserts need fresh produce. They need fresh fruits and vegetables to help our communities be strong and healthy. Across the nation, there are 23.5 million Americans that currently live in these food deserts. And according to USDA research, more than 2.5 million Americans live more than a mile away from a supermarket and do not own a car. So back in my district, in Buffalo and in Lackawanna, there are several food deserts where at least one-third of the population lives more than a mile from a supermarket or a large grocery store. They have little to no access to fresh, healthy food options, all because grocers have chosen not to invest in these neighborhoods. These communities are often underserved, low income, and at risk for diabetes and obesity. This gap in access to proper nutrition is simply unacceptable. And just this past year, we had two stark examples of the impact of food deserts in the Western New York community. We all know what happened on May 14th when a racist terrorist came to Buffalo and killed 10 people and injured 3 more. He chose that location, Topps Friendly Markets on Jefferson Avenue, because he knew it was located in a food desert, and he knew that Topps Friendly Markets was the only place within the local community for folks to shop. Because of that, there are souls that were lost that day. He knew that this community was predominantly Black, and people would be shopping that Saturday morning. Our community will never fully heal from that loss. On top of that, during the December blizzard, the Aldi supermarket in Buffalo's Broadway Fillmore neighborhood, which is once again one of the only full-service supermarkets in that community, was looted by a few bad actors. The result? A low-income community temporarily was left without convenient access to healthy, fresh foods. In both of these cases, Tops and Aldi prioritized the reopening of these critically important stores, and I commend them for that. But it only underscores how tenuous food security actually is for communities in food deserts. All New Yorkers, Mr. President, deserve access to fresh foods, regardless of zip code or socioeconomic status. Through the implementation of this bill, the Fresh Act, we're incentivizing opportunities for supermarkets to put down roots in urban and rural areas that currently lack sufficient access to healthy food. In turn, we're not only requiring them to provide nutritional, locally sourced produce, we're also requesting that they create local jobs for the surrounding communities that they choose to invest in. Through this legislation, we're attempting to right the wrongs and close the current gaps that exist by providing the kind of accessibility to healthy food options that everyone rightfully deserves. Again, I want to thank the Majority Leader, Andrea Stewart Cousins. I want to thank the Chair of Agriculture, Senator Michelle Hinchey, and all of my colleagues for supporting this important piece of legislation. With that, Mr. President, I vote aye.
Senator Kennedy to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 299, those senators voting in the negative are Senators Brisport, Griffo, Skoufis, and Walzik. Ayes 59, nays 4.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 305, Senate print 2096 by Senator Thomas, an act in relation to authorizing the County of Nassau assessor to accept an application for a retroactive real property tax exemption.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adabo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 305, those senators voted in the negative are Senators O'Mara and Skoufis, aye 61, nays 2.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 314, Senate print 3302 by Senator Sepulveda, enactment of the Environmental Conservation Law.
Read the last section.
Section 4 is extra effect 1 year after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 314, those senators voting in the negative are Senators Borrello, Gallivan, Griffo, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Steck, and Walzik. Ayes 55, nays 8.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 343, Assembly number 3534 by Assemblymember Santa Barbara, enactment of the Mental Hygiene Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act take effect on the 60th day, it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 343, those senators voting in the negative are Senators Borrello, Castaneri, Fitzpatrick, Martins, Walzik, and White. Ayes 58, nays 5.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 370, Senate print 3139 by Senator Mannion, enactment of the Private Housing Finance Law.
Read the last section.
Section 3 is actually in effect on the 180th day. It shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Aye, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 384, Senate print 2867 by Senator Rivera, enactment of the Social Services Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this action will take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Aye, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 437, Senate print 2515A by Senator Ramos, enactment of the Vehicle and Traffic Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act take effect on the 90th day, it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Ramos to explain her vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. This is an issue that is near and dear to my heart, particularly as the mother of two small boys, the age of 9 and 11. Actually, when I first ran for Senate back in 2018, right in the middle of our campaign, in our community, we lost one of our own. We lost a very small boy named Giovanni Ampuero to traffic violence. And actually, in the past year, in the year of 2022, we have lost a total of 18 children in New York City to traffic violence, mostly children from Brooklyn and Queens. That includes Leanne Mashni, Mario Rosario Jr., DeMonte McDonald, Yaakov Farhi, Jonathan Martinez from East Elmhurst in my district, Young Ann Lee, Davina Afakoba, Antonina Zalutska, Jesse Gill, Ashley Rodriguez, Alexandra Arija, Alisa Kolinovich, Mohamed Aith, Fernanda Hill, Tara Saucier, Danielle Hernandez, and two unknown children, while the ages of 1 and 18, whose names we do not know because their bodies were not recovered after they passed away. All of these children we lost in 2022, and we've lost a few in the course of this year as well. So we believe that this bill could actually help save lives as children come to and fro from school. The idea would be to create scramble crosswalks where all red lights for a brief moment are red so that children and even our school crossing guards can stay safe as they cross to and from school at both arrival and dismissal. So I thank all of my colleagues who are supportive of this bill. It will save lives, and it will especially save our children's lives. Thank you.
Senator Ramos to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 446, Senate print 3582 by Senator Hinchey, enactment of the tax law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed. Senator Gianaris, that completes the reading of today. Senator Gianaris, that completes the reading of today's calendar.
On to the controversial calendar, please.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 230, Senate print 1804 by Senator Addabbo, enactment of the Public Service Law.
Senator Lanza, why do you rise?
Mr. President, I believe there's an amendment at the desk I waive the reading of that amendment and ask that you recognize Senator Steck to be heard on the amendment.
Thank you, Senator Lanza. But upon review of the amendment, in accordance with Rule 6, Section 4B, I rule it non-germane and out of order at this time.
Accordingly, Mr. President, I appeal the ruling of the chair and ask that Senator Steck be heard on the appeal.
The appeal has been made and recognized, and Senator Steck may be heard.
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise to appeal the ruling of the chair as the amendment is germane to the underlying bill because this amendment would require that the state provide a cost analysis and transparency to the public of the state of New York of the cost of the Climate Leadership and Community Protection Act. And the underlying bill would require utilities to provide customers notice of any rate changes that are occurring. Now, the Climate Action Council scoping plan states that the cost of this plan is in the neighborhood of $300 billion, but that's a macro level analysis. It's certainly not detailed and certainly not being shared with the public. The state needs to do a more in-depth cost analysis so that ratepayers are well-informed prior to the transition and their rising costs in their pocketbooks. For what it's worth, $300 billion price tag is likely on the low side. As any of you that have worked in government for more than a few minutes, especially at the local level where you're actually hands-on managing projects, you know that state projects can escalate in cost very quickly. As a matter of fact, just a couple miles from here, the Port of Albany has a wind turbine that's been proposed. The original cost estimate for that turbine is $350 million. And current estimates today are it's going to cost $700 million. That's a doubling of the price, and that is just one of over 100 similar projects that's out there on the drawing board right now. New Yorkers have the right to know what it will cost them to retrofit their homes. They have the right to know what it will cost to transition from natural gas heat to geothermal heat pumps. New Yorkers have the right to know what it's going to cost for them to transition from gas-powered vehicles to electric vehicles. New Yorkers have the right to know what it will cost them to upgrade the electrical grid. And as somebody that's worked in nuclear engineering, I can tell you that what's on the radar for us to upgrade the state's electrical distribution system is staggering. New Yorkers have the right to know what it will cost to build a renewable project, which will be necessary to meet the mandates under the CLCPA. So for that reason, I urge you to reconsider that this is in fact germane because it's about transparency in people's electrical energy costs. The justification in the sponsor's memo on the bill says that that's important. It's unacceptable for them not to have that. And I just don't know how we incorporate the scope of $500 billion worth of improvements that's going to roll down onto their electric bills without making sure that we understand the cost analysis and, more importantly, that people are prepared and that we're transparent what those costs will be. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Steck. I want to remind the House that the vote is on the procedures of the House and the ruling of the chair. Those in favor of overruling the chair signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Request a show of hands.
A show of hands has been requested and so ordered. Announce the results.
Ayes 21.
The ruling of the chair stands and the bill in chief is before the House. Senator Gennaris.
We've agreed to restore this bill to the non-controversial calendar, so can we please take it up that way?
Upon consent, the bill has been restored to the non-controversial calendar. Secretary will read. Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gennaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Relation to calendar 230, voted in the negative. Senator Walzik. Ayes 62, nays 1.
The bill is passed. Senator Gennaris, that completes the reading of today's calendar.
Is there any further business at the desk?
There is no further business at the desk.
I move to adjourn until Wednesday, March 15th at 3 p.m., with the intervening day being a legislative day in deference to the expected storm tomorrow.
On motion and based upon the inclement weather pending tomorrow, the Senate stands adjourned until Wednesday, March 15th at 3 p.m.
Intervening
day being legislative.